Almost finished for the morning now, and already a number of vehicles tagged and towed for idling or parking in a no-stopping route. This truck delivering bread was ticketed. Another was towed. Toronto police want to get the message across. No blocking traffic during rush hour. It's all part of John Tory's plan to ease congestion within the city. The mayor is currently sitting down one-on-one with Dina.
He sure is live right now. Good morning, Mayor John Tory. So good to see you and Happy New Year. First things
first. Happy New Year to you, Dina, and to all the Breakfast Television viewers as well.
Well, you're making good on your promise. The crackdown begins today. As we see, it's already happening. How do we plan on combating and dealing with all of this congestion in the city and the gridlock? Talk to us about how you're enforcing it.
Well, I think it's really just about people changing their behavior. I mean, the signs have been up on those poles for years and years, decades, long before I came to the mayor's office saying no stopping, no standing, no parking during rush hour on major streets. And so I think it's just time people remembered that when they decide to flout the law and make a joke of the law, they're inconveniencing lots of other people trying to get home to their families or trying to get some work done. And so people just have to be considerate in their behavior. I look at Canada Post, for example, and I give them full credit. We criticize them all the time. They are changing the pickup times for a lot of their mailboxes downtown so their trucks are not blocking traffic. There's a good example of somebody who's taking the leadership that I'm trying to show on this issue and doing something about it. And I think it's just up to all of us to change our behavior a little bit.
There's a lot of businesses, though, you know, they have to deliver. We just saw that bread truck, and they figure, oh, it's just a couple of minutes. As we can see, you have a lot more people out there. How is that working out? Are they being pulled from the residential streets?
Yes, okay. They are. I mean, this is a decision of the police chief, but I asked for his cooperation and I got some cooperation. So we have quite a few police officers deployed in the downtown this morning to send the message. Really, I hope they don't have to tow and tag a lot of people, that people get the message. But the bottom line is, like they've done in cities like New York for a long, long time, we just have to find ways to make those deliveries differently. Do it around the corner. Do it at a different time. And the police will use their discretion. Our police are very good about that. They're not going to sort of, you know, if you're dropping your spouse off at work, they're not going to sort of say, aha, we've got you. You stop for 4 seconds. We're going to give you a ticket. So, but it's just a matter of people engaging in common sense behavior and the police being common sense, and it'll all work out.
Speaking of New York City and, you know, taxis and things like that, Christine Hubbard just tweeted from Beck. I'll read it to you. She says, staff recommended taxis should be able to sit at fire hydrants, as in some other cities. That was a year ago, and no movement there. Hashtag Teo Poly. So what do you say to that with all the taxis in the city?
That I'm going to be working with business, with the courier companies, with the Canada Post, the Trucking Association, the taxi industry, to find common sense ways, because they do have their business to do, and it's important. It's part of getting people around the city, too. But we're going to work on all of that to make sure we're not just enforcing the law, but that we're also making sure that people can get dropped off by cabs and can get picked up with cabs and so on. But bottom line, we can't have people getting themselves a coffee, getting their dry cleaning, shredding papers. I mean, a shredding truck. Why do you have to shred papers at 5 o'clock on a major street? You don't.
Yeah.
So we're going to stop that kind of thing. And then I think the traffic will move better and everybody will be happier.
And how about with the condos, construction? A lot of time there's the, you know, the renting of these crucial lanes for months at a time.
I want to see that dramatically reduced in both time and in terms of the number of lanes. Well, I think it's some cases we're just going to have to say no. You can't rent a lane. As in New York, again, you can do your construction inside your own property. And in other cases, we're going to have to say it's going to cost you a lot more as an incentive to get things done faster.
And so that it goes back into the city.
Exactly. So I think that, you know, there are ways to deal with all these things, but we have to deal with them. We've gone for years where we've just kind of said, well, it's okay. Maybe one day it'll get better. Well, it wasn't getting better. It was getting worse. And I heard from people and they said, we're electing you to go down there and do something about this. And so I'm trying to do something about it. And we're going to be talking later today about exactly the problem you talked about, which is one of the next items. Construction causing lanes to be closed for years, years at a time. And so we're going to deal with that too.
You are guaranteed a lot of foot traffic tonight. You are attending that very fun finals.
Yes,
go Team Canada. You're bringing
I'm taking my grandson.
7 years old?
He's 7 years old.
What's his name?
His name is John as well.
Hi, John.
And he is a Pittsburgh Penguins fan, though. I'm very upset with him. I've told him this won't do. I'm the mayor of Toronto. I'm a lifelong Leafs fan. But he loves Sidney Crosby. So I'm going to give him a little re-education tonight while we're watching the Canadian juniors beat the Russians.
Put it on, okay?
Exactly.
Well, enjoy the game tonight. And are you enjoying your time so far as mayor?
It's a demanding job, but I volunteered for it and I'm happy to have it. I'm privileged to have it.
And shout out to your wife too, because she's so supportive.
Oh, Barb's the best. Yeah, she and I went skating on New Year's Day and neither of us fell down.
I'm very impressed. Yeah, I was waiting for a little triple lutz.
Yeah, well, no, that's why we didn't fall down, because we didn't try that.
At John Tory Teo to find him on Twitter. Thank you so much for taking the time
today.
Right now, over to Tim.